not say anything to them and just kind of leave.
And not say anything to each other. We're just walking. We're walking.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. That's that. Hang on. I wanna. We haven't gone this way. We have no idea what's up this way first, though. That is actually.
This is the airlock.
Yeah.
That's
yes. Yes, but into where though? Where do these stairs go? What's this? What's we
it's
don't
an
know
airlock.
Anything.
It goes outside.
That was in character as well. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
It's an airlock.
Yeah.
It goes outside.
Is there windows here?
Nope.
Fuck.
Alright. Does the remote was just can I just open the door or is it locked?
You can open the door.
Alright, let's open it.
Okay, Savrok opens the door.
As I take a step back.
Yep.
And the door closes behind him. He opens the second door. He steps in. And...
I like to actually use my thermos, chemical detection thermos.
Okay, so the chemical detection thermos detects nothing of note.
Okay.
And here... And here. Okay, so Savrok opens the first door, it closes, he opens the second door, he uses his chemical detection thermos, and he steps forward. And there is a loud crack, and a bullet bounces off the hull next to his head, but misses
okay.
him.
Okay.
I run down this hallway.
How do you know the airlock's closed? You haven't heard anything.
I'm pretty sure inside a closed pressurized container, a gunshot is still going to sound like a muted gunshot.
Fair enough.
And yeah, microphone slut. With open helmet, which I keep
so
forgetting.
So you just leave me, you slut.
Yep. Savrok finds himself facing a middle-aged woman with sort of shoulder-length black hair that's graying around the roots. She's wearing a blood-stained... basic sort of like station suit with an armor pack over the top of it, so she's got a bit like a bulletproof vest on, and she's holding a toric pistol. He's also facing a sort of slightly Asian male with a drilling rig attached to his shoulders, very similar to the one that Blaster Toad is wearing. He's facing a person in a MET vest with a small assault rifle. Which is a bulletproof vest with a small assault rifle, and someone who is in a spacesuit, who is not armed with anything. She's a young woman, probably about 25, 26, and she's curled up in the corner behind the crates.
Yeah, how about you go try to intimidate them and cut off their hands?
Nope, I'm gonna... I want to roll diplomacy, explain I'm not here as danger. I am just here, trying to figure out what the shit happened. I'm a...
Rescue 19.
That went sideways.
So, rather than going for his shotgun or his pistol, Savrok throws
first
up his
time
hands.
In his life, he goes to talk, and since I'm not hearing any more gunshots, I'm slowly making my way back here.
Bearing in mind that his helmet's open and his sort of communication interface is open, so you can listen in on the conversation. As
well, basically,
on.
I didn't hear him scream in agony as he died. So I'm pretty sure after one gunshot and nothing else, and he's not dead, I'm going to slowly walk this way.
Showing a strange kind of flash of inspired diplomacy, Savrok calls out, wait, human. The sort of woman who took a shot at him, who was the middle-aged woman with black hair, she lowers her gun. She sort of looks at you. And she says to Savrok, can you prove you're human?
I don't know how I prove other than
I'm
blood
talking.
Test. I'm talking. I'm not trying to eat you, rip you to pieces. I don't know how else to prove it.
She is still pointing, she's still got her lower gun, but the security officer is still pointing his assault rifle at you. And the construction worker still has his drilling rig in his drilling rig set up, pointed in your direction. The middle-aged woman looks at you and she says, they can talk sometimes. Show us your chest.
Okay. I guess I gotta get out of my suit and step forward.
Okay, so you take probably about sort of like 3 or 4 minutes to pry open the front of your suit, and you step forwards. The woman with the pistol kind of snaps her fingers, and the guy with the drilling rig moves towards you. He's got 2 circular saws on the end of his drilling rig, very similar setup to Blaster Toad.
I walk through the first door at this point.
Okie dokie. And he looks at Savrook's chest, and he looks back at the woman, and he goes, "Clean." At which point the assault rifle lowers, and the guy steps back, and he kind of looks you up and down, and he goes, "How the fuck did you get here?"
Does Saravok still have his helmet on?
He does, yes. He's opened the front of his suit, but he's still wearing his helmet.
Okay, but he's still in the suit. He's just opened the front. Okay.
Yep.
Damn it.
Yep.
I wanted to yoink it back through the airlock.
I'm gonna...
You were gonna steal his suit.
Yeah, I could use the radio for another interface.
Such a big bag. I'm gonna...
I'm going to announce to Saravok that I'm coming in.
Yeah, I'm gonna let them know that I have somebody else.
Who's there? I'm coming in.
Okay, so...
Yeah.
Savrok declares that he's got someone else with him and that they're going to be coming in, at which point immediately weapons come back up.
I'm going to step off to the side.
And as Blastoise comes around the corner, he receives the same.
I've already heard this, so I've started opening my suit while in the safety of these 2 doors.
Okie dokie. So Blaster Toad is basically stripping off before he enters the room. You're going to have a semi-naked Blaster Toad just walking into the room. Semi-naked Jake Long.
I come in with my beautifully chiseled chest with sparkling of manly chest hair that just exudes handsomeness.
Surprise, surprise, Jake Long takes the first possible opportunity to get bare-chested.
I wasn't quite thinking that hairy, but sure.
So,
such a floppy cock.
Same situation. The guy with the double rotators approaches you and kind of looks at your chest for a bit, and then decides that you are clean, whatever that happens to mean, backs off, and the guns are lowered. Young man in the security uniform kind of shoulders his way past you and closes, makes sure the airlocks are closed behind you, and then returns to his position. There's some storage crates and a couple of lockers with spacesuits.
Out of character, guys. Do you think Jake Long would be of just an opinion from you two? Would he be of a stable enough mind right now to make a joke at this point after what's all happened, or is he pretty straight face broken?
I mean, you did attempt to have a woman mutilated.
To be perfectly honest, I think like the level of focus and sanity that your characters have is probably like bouncing up and down the shop. You will probably have moments of completely cogent sanity where just like the situation itself snaps into place and you're just like, right, I actually understand what's going on. I understand like this situation, so I can deal with this situation.
Okay. So I'm going to take a step forward then.
Yep.
And do a quick nod to the woman who seems to be leading the group. Say, okay, now let's see yours.
Strangely enough, this doesn't get a laugh. Strangely enough, the woman opens her shirt immediately.
Okay. So now with her shirt open, they're like, okay, so what am I supposed to be looking for? And nice.
So the woman kind of looks at you for a second. It shows on her face that she's confused. And then slowly it dawns on her that essentially she's just opened her shirt for no fucking reason. because you are a clueless stooge. At which point,
I'm happy for myself right now. That was good.
Yes, it was a nice little bit of brevity in the campaign when considering what the fuck's happened recently.
Yup.
Oh,
So she slowly does her shirt back up, and she kind of looks you up and down, and she says, "You fucking prick." she looks at you and she says, she sort of gestures at the security guy and she says, like, "How the fuck did you guys get here?"
Well, yeah.
Well, a lot of luck.
Long story or short story?
She looks at you and she sort of looks around at the group and she goes, "Short."
This dickbag had no brains, so we're stuck here because he likes the idea of dealing with freaking space zombies, and our ship flew away.
He killed Fluffy.
So we're just having this argument in front of them? Like, we're just...
Oh my fucking god.
You fucked twat.
Oh my fucking god.
You're the one that we're here for, and our ship ran away. We were here to save you, by the way.
Wait,
but you twat.
Stop. Savrek, do you genuinely say he killed Fluffy?
I do genuinely say.
Oh my fucking god.
You are such a dick.
Right.
Porcelain doll raping, cut off people's hands for fun.
Wait. Stop. The moment he says that, around the corner, behind some of the crates,
Not the broken girl!
There is just a howl of inconsolate pain. Just this howl of pain. From the girl who's lying in the corner. And fucking hell.
You are such a douche!
Hey, you know who said it's my fault we're stuck here?
You're the only one who vocally refused to leave.
Yup,
that's all you gotta freaking... Hey, can I, like, borrow one of your heavier caliber weapons to deal with this right now? All I got is this stupid little pistol. Fuck you!
Fucking hell.
Sorry about the dog,
that's not how I expected... Wait, that's not how I expected that to go.
God damn it!
Yup.
Like, how sideways did that conversation go?
Just this howl of inconsolate pain from the corner from the young woman who's in her sort of early 20s, who just starts howling and weeping, and just like everyone in the room just like stares at you like.
I killed the family pet.
When you guys rewatch this video, you will see how unimpressed my face is right now. And it's just, fuck you.
Oh my god.
As I said, it might have been best if you'd just gone to the buggies.
Okay. Yup. I told you not to kill the dog.
I didn't expect him just to blurt it out.
Well, how do they respond to my retort of a porcelain doll raping hand cutting off for fun?
Oh,
like, do they even intelligibly acknowledge that, or are they just like, what the hell are these two on about?
They're all staring at you like you're creatures from like a like. They're all staring at you like you're fucking space zombies.
Freaking space zombies.
Are any weapons aimed at my direction?
Yes. All the fucking weapons are aimed at you two. Both of you have weapons aimed at you.
Okay, then.
Oh, you've broken the DM. Oh.
What's that?
You have broken the DM.
I've broken the DM. Oh my god.
On our first, like, actual campaign, too. That's I'm quite proud of that now.
Impressive, yeah.
I know, right?
High five. Damn.
Like, oh, I'm not pink right now. Sorry, I just realized this whole time I haven't been playing as my pink character. There we go, that's better.
Whew. Like, this campaign is like so messed up. on so yeah. many levels. I've had campaigns where we had characters that sexually assaulted undead dragons, and it was not this messed up.
Wow.
Okay.
Necrobestiality, awesome.
I'm somewhat proud of that.
Right.
So, I mean, I technically didn't even do anything that terrible yet.
What?
Technically. See? And yet. Technically and yet.
Apparently, you have to rewatch, like, this video and the previous one. Because you will see how messed up, like, after rewatching it, I was like, holy crap, my character's, like, screwed up. And I didn't realize it while playing it. When you rewatch this, you're going to be like, the shit did I do? Full seriousness,
I've done
dude.
Things.
Full so seriousness.
Guys, but
Basically, you're being essentially kind of like forcibly ejected from the airlock now, back into the station.
Okay.
At gunpoint.
You just got pushed at the airlock. At least the right side of the airlock.
So essentially now what you've done is you've caused one woman to have a complete and utter mental breakdown, walked to the other side of the station, and caused another woman to have a complete and utter mental breakdown.
But I saw some titties. Like, there was a plot. There was a bright side to this.
Okay, you know what? I'm gonna just bang on the door and yell, end the thing, and I killed the thing in the test tube. If that helps. Just so, sort of throw that out there.
So you bang on the airlock door and yell, I killed the thing in the test tube, if that helps.
Yeah. Yeah, just... I don't know what else to say to make things better. does that...
How is that supposed to help?
Because it seemed like it was sort of, you know...
Wait, he's like, rolling all the dice.
See all these dice?
Yeah.
Like, if every single one of them comes up the highest number it possibly can, that will help. No. No, it doesn't. It doesn't fucking help.
Okay, so while he's still there at the airlock, I walk up behind him, and because, like, he had to get pretty close to think that his voice was going to penetrate through there at all intelligibly, I just quickly take my hand and quickly jam it into the back of his helmet, causing it to bounce off the airlock door.
Okay, so
dumbass, and keep walking.
Right. Okay.
Get.
So they hear one last thump and then silence. I wonder how that's sitting with them.
I don't know if to be proud of you guys or pissed off.
Why? What have we done?
Do you know why? Do you know why I'm pissed off?
Why?
There is about 2.5 hours worth of fucking writing. There is 3 A4 pages detailing shit that you could have learnt and shit these people know and equipment and all sorts of fucking things in that fucking airlock. And you have just literally, like, they will not fucking let you guys back in. You have just destroyed hours of this campaign's work.
To be fair, though, they don't have to let me back in. I do have a cutter.
That I was thinking as well. I kind
of... And then, like, just... if Saravok wants to continue his reign of terror and attempts to intimidate these people... and then, you know, cut off their hands afterwards.
I only cut off the hands of things that are not...
Well, these people all had, like, guns pointed at you, so I figure you thought they were a threat and just, like, hands are fair game now.
Nope.
Oh, fuck.
Not quite. No. Do we want to try to coral ripper the door and you smoke bomb them so they're...
Wait, what? Now we're, like, covering them in, you know, like, flame retardant shit, too?
Coral and making the door, smoke bomb them so it disorients them, and then incapacitate them so we can explain the full gravity of the situation.
Because that's gonna help. Okay, let's do a verbal playthrough of how this would go down. Okay, so I would expend 6 rounds of ammunition to cut through the door, At that point, if people didn't open fire on us immediately, and this is just how this is playing out in my head, then I would throw a smoke bomb, which you assume is not going to elicit a response from these folks to shoot the hell out of us. Then we fill their lungs with burning red vapor particle crap flame retardant, which they're going to be so happy about, as the one chick is now having red streams down her face as she cries of dead dog and now chokes on particle in the air, and then we can't see shit because it's all going down, and they still don't shoot at us. You then want to explain our situation and think this is going to go okay.
I said, like, incapacitate, as in completely.
Now you want to kill them?
No.
And then explain to them how this is?
Shoot first, talk later. Shit. Okay, you know what? Let's just, okay, fine. We'll do it.
Go to the buggies? Go to the buggies? Yeah, let's go to the buggies.
Yep. Go to the buggies. God damn it. God damn it.
Oh. Oh, okay. Yeah, so we walked around that edge and then we came around and...
I'm...
Are you okay, Droid?
He's like, I'm never gonna DM for you assholes again.
Oh. You are both a DM's pleasure and a DM's nightmare. just...
So you say we're good at this? This is a thing we should continue? Yeah. Or is this like, you never speak of this again. Do not D20 ever. I am burning your set of dice.
Okay, so I'm posting the links to the two buggies pictures in Discord.
Go.
So, basically...
I want the techno buggy.
Yeah, you have the choice between the two buggies. You've got a buggy that's a lightly armored multi-wheel... quite low to the ground thing with got some scientific research equipment on it, and then you've got the cargo tab? Buggy.
Damn it, I can't find the. There's the game.
There's the game.
Well, I've got so many things open, I'm like clicking through programs. I'm like, where the hell is Tabletop Simulator? Oh,
I'm broken.
That one.
Okay, that one.
Okay.
I've got an idea. I already said I wanted the techno buggy, so I called dibs on it.
Yep.
How about we race? Okay. Like, fuck it all, we got to this point. I
to where?
I don't know, but you are a hand-cutting-off murdering psychopath to not deal with you in a smaller enclosed space than a space station. I'm suggesting we race buggies. Because why the hell not at this point?
All right.
Plus, I don't want a long-ass conversation if this is like a two-hour drive.
Fair enough.
Okay, I called the techno buggy, though.
Okay, fine.
Right, okay, can you both roll a navigate check for me?
Oh, fuck, I forgot how to pilot.
Shit.
Navigation check is 12 plus 5, which is your navigation, so you get 17. And Savrok, what's your navigation check?
Looking for pilot. So 4?
No, not pilot, navigation, which is wisdom. Wisdom based, yep. If you don't have any ranks in it.
Oh, damn. Okay,
plus 3.
Okay, I don't know if this is going to show up on the camera for people later, but like, how intense I've been getting into this is like, I have sweat dripping down the inside of my glasses now to the point where I can't see. Like, I've been going balls to the wall with this.
Oh. Okay, so roll a wisdom check for me as you don't have navigator.
Yep.
Okay. So, you both climb into your respective buggies and you both boot up the systems. And you both kind of like start fiddling through with the navigation systems. Savrok, being that he is in the cargo buggy, and the vessel, the station is having a lot of cargo delivered, which is being taken somewhere else, actually manages to find essentially like a favorited location. So essentially he's gone into the GPS history, into the sat-nav history, and he found a favorited location. Blaster Toad, meanwhile, is looking through the maps. And in his particular science buggy, he notices that a lot of the area around a particular part of the moon has been researched and investigated and scienced up to the nines. So you both have a possible location. You both have a possible direction in which to drive. So with your suit comms, you have an opportunity to basically both say that you found something and you both have a place you could possibly go to.
Okay.
Are they both the same coordinates if we're sharing this information? Or are they separate
coordinates? Do you share the coordinates? Do you share
the coordinates because we've got to have a finish line to race to.
Okay, yeah. So you have two separate coordinates. They are both approximately probably about a 45-minute drive to a 60-minute drive from the base, and they are both inside craters. However, they are off at roughly 45-degree angles from each other in relation to the base. So you'd assume that between the two of them is, again, another 45 to 60
minutes. So it's like a big triangle.
Yep.
Okay, I'm going to suggest we go to the cargo one, the one that mine is favored
at. Not the science the shit out
due to the fact.
Like, apparently there's something interesting enough that people are sciencing crap.
But if
like they did all the science.
If things have been disappearing unmarked from the cargo to this, wherever this area is.
Things have been disappearing unmarked, but it's a triangular location, which means, okay, if we follow some logic, that both bases, the one that cargo was going to, and the one that cargo was coming from, had interest in the science the shit out of it place. It is a very interesting place.
Cargo may have things that we could use in defense of this.
What else do we need? Like, anywhere we go to, we can like scrap stuff off walls to make stuff. I'm a crafting scavenger dude, and we all got plenty of ammo. We haven't expended too much of that yet.
That's true.
You want to go to the science-y place?
Let's science it up. Let's go to Science World.
Yay!
Okay, so...
and you know...
Masato, can you
now
roll
that
a DC?
He is off radio with me?
Yep.
I'm like, yeah, I don't want to deal with him. I'm going to drive to the other place. The cargo stuff sounds interesting.
Okay.
Right. So, first off... Toad, roll a DT 15 will check for me.
DT 15. So a 20 or?
D20, and you need to get above a 15, including your will save.
Okay.
To succeed.
Yay!
You do not succeed. You plonk yourself down in the science vessel's piloting seat, and you grab hold of the controls, and you immediately curl yourself up into a little ball as the sound of barking dogs fills your brain, and you fail to be able to pilot the ship. The...
You're such a dick. You're laughing way too hard at this asshat.
I did warn you.
Oh, but now he's
trying to pilot.
Bark, bark.
So, so, Sam, would you like to do a pilot check for your buggy?
Yes.
Okay, so you plonk yourself down in the scrolls. Although you don't have any experience with sort of cargo buggies, it's pretty similar to the basic Land Rovers and Land Speeders that you're used to. So you manage to get the engine humming. And you do notice the fact that, like, Blaster Toad's engine isn't turned on yet, but you both
decided
to go...
It
couldn't
even turn on the freaking lights.
Screw
like, it won't even turn into reverse.
I get a head start. It's all good. I'm racing. That's it. Not my fault. He's handicapped.
So you're gonna drive off and just leave him here.
Yeah, I'm just gonna gun it. He said he wanted the race. I'll race him, dumbass.
Okay, so Savrock peels out of the.
Gilson, how fast do you think that dreaded, horrible monstrosity thing goes? Like, let me get a picture of this back up on here for everybody. Because we haven't seen a picture on the thing yet, so copy that. So this is what Saravok is driving. Or 50-foot ant. How fast do we think that thing actually freaking moves? It's like, okay, so, putt.
Right. He peels out of the cargo bay in comparison to Blaster Toad, who is sitting there doing nothing.
Oh, fuck you. That was uncalled for.
Or fluffy.
So, Blaster Toad takes, let's do this. Let's do 2d6s to see how many minutes Blaster Toad takes to pull himself back together and remember how to pilot ships. 7 minutes. So he gets a 7 minute head start, and Blaster Toad finally remembers that, you know, his brain isn't actually filled with barking dogs, and he actually does understand basic controls, because, you know, it's a steering wheel and pedals. It's not massively complicated. And so Blaster Toad
digging it in there, eh?
Yep.
Yep. Knife and twist. I love the fact that your like data cards are like filled with huge amounts of stuff and like people you've met and like situations and things and like what is this and what is that and all this stuff. And like literally you just walk in and go, he killed a puppy. Fucking hell. Sorry, that's still broken.
You're such a douche.
Oh, I'm so broken. I am so broken.
Okay.
Oh, now my glasses are fogging up again, damn it.
Okay.
Okay.
So,
what happens?
You both head out. Unfortunately for Savarok, he is actually driving the slower machine once Blaster Toad manages to pull himself back together. And over the course of the 60-minute drive, Blaster Toad manages to kind of creep up on Savarok slowly as... Savarok's going for the science base. This actually works quite well because Savarok actually went for the science section. So Savarok goes for the science section. He ends up at a crater. The floor's been dug out. There is some signs of research, but essentially it's a dugout crater. At the base of the crater, where most of the digging is, there is like a crystalline structure. Looks a little bit like quartz or silicon crystals, and they've been chipped away at, but mostly they're intact. And Savarok waits around at the science section for like 4 or 5 minutes and realizes that Toad's not coming, and so turns around and heads for the location that he wants to go for, which was the cargo location. Meanwhile, Toad has driven off to the cargo location himself. And,
oh, he doesn't come back for me? He's not like, oh no, maybe he's still stuck at the station and wastes another 40 minutes? He's just like, screw that, I'm gonna go to the other place. I want to go there first.
Well, I'm already retarded.
Well,
I mean, okay.
What's your choice, sir? Bob, do you come out for the guy that like might be broken down in the Jeep or like his thing doesn't work or whatever, or do you just like, I want to check this other place out, I should go there alone? Keeping in mind that you do not know that I took off to the other location. Last thing you know is that my Jeep wasn't moving and not even turning on.
I assume you would have radioed if something went horribly wrong using the vehicle radio, so I'm just gonna head on over to the other one, because you're not that dumb. Come on. Give yourself a little bit of credit.
Okay,
fair enough, yeah.
Oh, 54 amp got disconnected.
My game just rage quit on me. Okay. It's just like, no, quit.
You know, just in case I'll save the game here.
Yeah, failed to start game. What?
Wow, we've destroyed Blaster Toad's computer.
No, 50s.
Even Blaster.
No,
sorry,
me.
50s. Even 50s, yeah, computer is like, nope, I'm done with
this. This is too messed up. I'm done.
Okay. Oh. It is not showing up on my game list of games I'm playing. What the dick?
Unless you're playing it now.
Nothing's showing up. Nope, nothing. There you go. Okay.
Yeah.
That was just AIDS. Oh well.
So links in Discord's Blaster Toad.
Okay. Show the picture first, I guess?
Yeah, show the picture first.
Okay, where's my drinks? God damn it.
I'm in so much need of alcohol after this. Where is it?
Yeah, pretty much. Shit. God damn it.
Literally, you two are just going to go down the pub and just like, it's like 8 o'clock in the morning, the pub's just open.
I've got 3 bottles of stuff here. I don't even have to leave. I can just curl up on my couch, put a blanket on, watch some Deadpool, and like cry myself to sleep.
Wow. Okay, so,
Welcome back.
Welcome back.
Ooh, okay, so, let's calm down, Ted.
Toad is the first one to roll into this base, and he rolls into this base roughly an hour before Savrok does. Because Savrok first had to head off to the other base and then sit around for 10 minutes waiting for him to turn up, and then realize that he wasn't going to turn up. This base is dug into the ground. It's inside a slight impressed crater, not a particularly deep crater. And it's dug into the ground and is covered with a sort of like moon dust and moon dirt. It's essentially a hidden base. However, it's also only partially constructed. It's obvious that it's only partially constructed because there is a construction mech sitting outside, sitting on the dirt. And one second, let me grab open this again. Open this again. Open links again. And the construction mech is in Discord, because of course it won't let me paste bloody things in. And the construction mech is a four-legged squat mech. It's got no cockpit or arm in front or anything like that. It's got two actuator arms. On the sides are holstered tools. And the holstered tools that you can't see in the photograph are basically a giant magnetic coil ripper, a giant welding arc tool, a giant cutting tool, a couple of big scoops. It's obviously a mech designed for constructing stations on low gravity planets. You can't see it, but you can guess from your experience, Toad, that because it's designed for low gravity planets, it probably has some kind of hydraulic or pneumatic spike on the bottom of each foot that it can drive into the ground to
okay,
fix itself in place.
Very stable unit.
Yeah, and it's not going to be a quick thing. It's going to chug along and it's going to do the job. They're usually reasonably easy to pilot. And this thing, again, no armor.
Until you try to start piloting it and you think of dead dogs.
Yes.
That. Stop.
Pink
of
dead dogs. hey, it wasn't my fault that it was the pilot skill that got hit. It was just me that came up with the sick and twisted nature of what was going to happen to you when something happened.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So we have you arriving at this base.
Holy crap!
And,
is it like 4.5 hours we've been in this now?
Yeah, roughly.
Yep.
Holy shit.
Shall we wrap it up here? Shall we wrap it up with Blaster Toad arriving at the base and Savrok getting pissed off that Blaster Toad has left him behind?
I'm good to keep going.
Okay, that's fine by me.
Okay.
We're all like, just keep going. This is going to be like a 10-hour D&D session. That you
I can't do that.
I know. I still have to wake up for work tomorrow, but I'm good for like another hour.
Oh, God.
Dude.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay, so there's a map in Discord of the original base.
Yes.
Or the base you're arriving at. Meanwhile...
Oh, thanks.
Yep.
Meanwhile, with Savrok kind of on his way, probably a slightly pissed off Savrok on his way.
I'm a little bit choked.
Blaster Toad arrives. And first issue he comes across is that the door is locked. The airlock door is locked.
Interior or exterior?
The exterior door. The exterior airlock door is it will not respond to your attention.
Like no response at all?
There's a control panel.
Is this locked?
There's a control panel. When you push the buttons, the control panel is kind of like the lights change color.
Sorry, just the way when you're like the way you described it at first, I'm like, what, it's dead control panel? But no, it's...
No, okay. The control panel has life.
Okay. I'm going to pull out the nifty hacky computer thing.
You forget that I still have that.
Since when? I gave it to you temporarily.
I never gave it back to you. I never said I did.
He kind of has a point. He never did give it back to you.
And you never gave me back my spare clip of holdout rounds, of which I had.
Yeah,
37.
I did after the first one.
Oh, that's right. Oh, well, I still have. Then I. That's right. I took it back for the second thing, and then I never gave it back. I'm an asshole. You gotta wait for me.
No, I don't. I got a magnetic coil ripper, or I could just try hacking the thing.
All right, try hacking it. Roll a one. Permanently log yourself out.
No, you know what? You know what? This is an exterior airlock. It makes sense for the exterior airlock to be locked really tight. After that, though, like, hidden secret base, why do you need to lock the interior doors? I'm gonna cut through the bitch. Bad idea, but I'm gonna cut through it. Okay. Is it like extra armor, or is it just a standard 3 rounds to get through it?
You're going to have to expend 6 rounds per door, so you're going to have to go through 12 rounds to break this.
Is it worth it now?
You forget that I picked up, like, 7 spare batteries?
This
okay, let's
true.
See. I've got 8 Ripper batteries.
Yep.
Plus, I've got the 5-pound or whatever, the other battery from the super rifle that has 40 rounds in it.
Yep.
And I've got a makeshift Ripper battery with 17 rounds in it. I've got no problem with ammo right now.
Fair enough.
So I just got through the first door.
Okay.
Do I have to do like a reflex or something for the decompression?
Because the space between the two doors, there's not enough air for it to do anything to you.
Okay. And then I will reload, or I will use, or do I have to do it continuously, the ammo?
In what sense?
In the sense that I've got 1 round left in this battery. Or I've got a charge for one in this. Can I use this and then continue to use 2? Or should I pull this battery out, have 1 charge left in it, and then have to put a new one in to do a full continuous 3-round burst to burn through in a continuous thing?
Roll a structural check.
I got a 9-8. Damn it! It fell backwards. That's on stream too, as it's like I'm hovering over it and it's 9 and then it rolled backwards.
You assume that you can do damage with a single burst and then continue cutting later.
Okay, so I'll expend that round. So I've got a full thing down. And then I will pull one of my... Actually, I'm going to pull my my makeshift battery out. That is out of my inventory.
Okay.
So I'm reloading with 17 rounds and expending another 5?
5, yes. Okay.
You good at math, man. You good at math.
12 rounds I have left then.
Okay, so you cut through the two doors. Make a reflex save for me.
I knew this was going to happen. Too early on the doors. Please, 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 fuck you.
1? Is it a 1?
3.
It's a 3.
So what, I got a 5 with my reflex, or what's my reflex here? Let's see. Reflex is plus 5, so I've got a 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah, that's nowhere near enough.
Thanks for breaking that to me gently.
You take 2 damage to the face as a piece of spacesuit comes whipping out of the airlock and smacks you in the face.
Money shot.
Seriously?
Oh, come on. There has to be some, at least one joke.
Okay. So I'm going to search these, I'm assuming, cargo containers.
They are suit lockers, and they contain basic spacesuits.
All right,
I'm gonna check this door then. Can I open it?
Yes. Make an intelligence roll for me, Toad.
Dude, that's me. You moving around? I know that because of the fact I'm a giant dick.
Okay. So intelligence 16 plus 1, 17.
Right.
Hi, Matt.
I'm going to explain this in terms that Jake Long would understand. Space shoot 30-minute oxygen. Base station, no airlock. Open door, no air. Very bad.
Wait, there's no oxygen at all in this partially set up.
Well,
space
you've just blown open the.
You just
the
ripped off the.
Yeah, but there's a second door. Airlock door here.
Yes, there is.
Yes, but
I would not recommend trying to magnetic rip through it.
No, but if is that door open? Like, can I cycle through that airlock?
No.
I am going to search these suit racks and see how many bottles of oxygen I have.
Okay, so
I arrived at the space station. Can't I arrive yet? For the long God.
You're probably just pulling up as he's finished searching.
Okay.
As you pull up, you see the front door has basically been ripped to tatters. You also see the construction mech outside. You see the fact that this is dug into the floor. Roll a spot check for me, Savrik.
Okay. Find my die.
Spot is plus 9. So you get... 9 plus 9, 18. There is something behind the base.
I will drive around behind it and take a quick look. See,
have there you is announced yourself very... or no?
I have not. I'm
okay,
just
so I don't even
you...
know that you're here. Okay.
Nope.
Savrok drives around the outside of the base, around the back of the outside of the base, behind this hump of sand and dirt that Blastito didn't notice because he was so focused on the base. And getting inside, behind this hump of moon dust, there's another small impression and a small planetary shuttle.
Okay.
If you leave without me, I'll fucking kill you.
It doesn't. it doesn't have any kind of magnetic lane connection. So, like, if he left without you, he'd take like 45, 50 years to get to the nearest habited planet.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
You know, how about you leave then?
I was gonna...
just die in space. Before
Dick Nuts there said anything, I'm gonna head back and let go and realize he ripped the door off, put my helmet up, make sure I'm not dying out of, you know, like a jackass, and inform him that there's a ship so he can GTFO, possibly, eventually, maybe.
Okay,
or at least
so...
transmit.
You've dug your way through the front door, and you've been searching through suits now for about probably 20, 30 minutes, just like digging out bottles and like pulling things out of lockers and throwing things on the floor. And you've managed to dig up like 6 extra bottles, but they're short EVA bottles.
So they just another 30 minutes or no?
They're about 15 minutes apiece.
Really?
Yep.
Lamest oxygen bottle ever.
They're literally just little, like, hand-sized bottles of EVA oxygen designed for going from shuttle to base and from base to the cargo pods or to the rovers. At this point, Savrik sticks his head through the door and points out there's a shuttle.
Okay.
Reaction, please.
That was it.
Hey, that's it.
I'm looking through... I'm digging through stuff, and you're like, there's a shuttle. I'm like, okay.
It's
and I'm just digging through shit.
Okay, how about, it's a plan. It's an interplanetary shuttle, not just it's not a bus, you jackass. It's not like a short bus that you normally ride on. It goes from planet to planet. You might want to take a look. Being as you're the ship guy. That's why we brought you along. Clearly not your skill at arms. All of this is in character. I am salty that you left me behind and expecting me to just, you know, go there and do nothing.
While trying to register what Theravok says about shuttles, I'm just thinking of the name Fluffy and I keep digging through stuff.
Wow, Blastitone is so broken, it's great.
Well, you see, like, as soon as I think of piloting, dogs bark.
Yep.
So I'm like, shuttle? Fluffy. Fuck that, it's out of my mind. I'm digging through shit. I'm not thinking about that. Eat a dick. You put this on me. I'm just playing it.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So since I'm welcomed with
a sneaky bastard.
Hey, and then yes, sir.
The door. And I keep digging through shit.
Okay, one sec. Mom's finally home. I'll be back. Take a quick 2, 3, 4, 5 minute break. I don't know. Not that long, but 2 minutes.
Okay, dokes.
Okay, so while I'm waiting for him to deal with the door, I want to go outside and look at that mech.
Where are you going?
Out to look at the excavation station building mech suit.
Okay, dokes. So you go out to the mech suit. It's parked very short distance away from the base. It's parked off to one side. It's got a couple of excavation claws. It's got a very large version of a magnetic coil ripper. It's got a couple of welding rigs, a circular saw rig, and they're all designed so that they're a bit like giant versions of hand tools. The mech can pick them up out of holsters on its legs and use them in the same way someone would have like a drill holstered on their side and would use the drill when working.
I want to inspect the unit and see if it has a inbuilt oxygen supply.
Go ahead.
So spot check then?
Yeah, go with spot check.
Because the dice have just been loving me tonight. I got a 14.
That's not
actually
bad.
Not horrible compared to what I've been getting.
So you climb about on the thing and you notice that there's connector pipes for connecting a spacesuit to the seat that the pilot sits in. Digging through and kind of looking in, you can see that it's not got a life support system, but it's certainly got an oxygen management system. It's a bit like a combination between a couple of large capacity oxygen tanks and a rebreathing apparatus that scrubs carbon dioxide from the air.
Okay.
All right, I am back. Oh.
Usage I would see from what kind of time frame I'd see from that?
From a rough guess, you'd guess that this is like a 4 or 5 hour sort of like before it has to be recharged by the base. It's probably a 4 or 5 hour rig.
All right. Okay, so I'm back. I'll use the network interface thing on the door and try and open it. Open the first one without any issues. All right, I'll roll that. Thank you for pulling out for me. Yes! Oh.
19 dang, plus 2 for intellect and 2 for the machine, 23. You manage to interface with the base and you look into it and basically you find out that the whole thing is rigged as a kind of like defensive network and that literally this is the sort of thing you'd associate it with is kind of like a military style lockdown.
Okay.
With a little bit of work and a little bit of time and effort, combined with the interface device you have and the skill you have, you manage to basically con it into thinking that it's trying to keep things in instead of keep things out, or at least you think you try and con it into keeping things in rather than keeping things out, which means that you can now open the doors inwards.
Yeah, I will. Yeah.
I assume the mech just. Correct me if I'm wrong, is of size since it's meant for building stations that also works inside this area?
It would be about, like, the four legs would take about 20 foot by 20 foot square, so it would have to squeeze its legs together to get through the door, but it could walk through the airlock.
I'm going to bring the mech through the airlock.
Roll a pilot skill. Well, roll a will save.
shit, dogs.
Yeah, it's the dogs again. Oh.
10.
11.
What? I got an 8 and a plus 2 will save.
Plus 3 will save.
I'm only seeing 2 on my sheet.
Oh, freaky. Okay, plus 2 will save it is then. It's DC 15 to defeat your psychological damage, so unfortunately you can't pilot the mech.
How long do I have to wait, or is it not like the truck?
You could sit in the mech and just like try and get hold of your psych.
They could sit in the mech, have a good or mech, have a good cry, and then try again. Or,
but remember, we also only have 14 minutes left of air. Now probably down to about 12. So
yeah, roughly.
So
you would have to sit and wait for 5 minutes before you could retry.
So bring an oxygen tank with you. Like, I'm in character right now. I'm telling you, bring an oxygen tank with you if you get a shot. Right, I'm gonna open the first airlock door,
and I'm sitting in a seat, strapped in with a seatbelt, crying to myself in my helmet.
Yeah, okay. And I'll wait for you to pull yourself together and just deal
really
with what you need to.
The first human thing you do.
Well, I have to wait. I either leave you outside to die and just kind of let myself in, or I do the good thing, which also benefits me greatly in the fact that I have somebody else to watch my ass. I will let you watch my ass. No homo. Let me preface that by saying no homo. You can watch my ass. I have faith in your ass watching skills. Shit. Okay.
Okay, so Savrik waits for you to recover your sanity, and you climb into the mech. It's not a complicated mech to pilot. You've seen things like this before, and you trundle it forwards. Can you make a pilot check to get it through the confined space that is the door?
Well, if I critically fail this and just like run it into the wall,
it's myself.
Okay.
13.
It takes a bit of scrape and it loses some of its nice yellow paint, but it manages to kind of scrape its
There's
way
as well
the
as the cargo truck into the med bay.
Yep. Pretty much.
Okay.
Are you okay there, Droid?
He is not.
So Savrik's standing there, like sort of like waiting, kind of standing there, like what's going on? At which point, a giant ass fucking mech starts to claw its way in through the fucking airlock.
The best thing is, like, through the first airlock, it's just like giant claw comes through and starts pushing the door aside because it had just been like rippered through. There's no way to open that door now. Like, it has to pull itself through those doors. And he's just like standing there in an airlock and he sees this. That'd be great.
Okay, so I'm hyperventilating now. I'm gonna run. I was not expecting that. I'm focusing intently on the airlock. Some big ass thing comes. I'm just gonna get wrecked. Close my door then. Okay, I'll be quiet-ish. But okay, yeah, I'm gonna grab some air tanks because I don't want to run out of oxygen now that I'm hyperventilating and partially shitting myself. Dead silence, and then rip, tear, smash, screeching of metal. No, thank you.
This is a great mental image. Sarah yep. Bach pissing himself in fear. Not the mech. Who cares about the mech? Just Sarah Bach pissing himself.
More just unexpected loud noise in an absolute dead space silence.
Actually, if you want to make a token and give it the mech
shape. Yes, yes, I do.
We can even give it the right size for the mech and
So it's basically going to be like this sized, just
a little bit larger than that, actually.
Nice.
It takes up it takes up 4 square by 4 square, so it's going to be quite like a.
That's okay.
Like that?
A little bit larger. That's 3x3. And there we go. That's about 4x4.
There we go.
This is our 4x4 mech. Just sitting there with
All right,
Jake Long.
I need you to open the door.
Okay. No. due to the fact that as soon as we open this door, all the air is gone from in here.
How's that?
No
we
air.
We got a cyclable airlock.
Because
Toad,
you
look
ripped
at the
through
airlock.
These two doors. Look at how big that is. Look at how big this is. You can't fit this in there and block off one side. Holy physics.
I'll make work.
Nope. Either you leave that, but I'm just going to step in here and lock this from the inside. Just and
oh,
communicate
I can see
with
where
you.
This is fucking going.
Because I'm going to go through here and I'm just going to sit in here and just explain to you why it's a terrible idea that we try to bring this in here. We'll
I'm not
die.
Staying out here.
You're not, but
I'm not staying out here.
No,
I put the claw in the door and tried to mechanically
move it open. No, you're not bringing that in. You're not bringing that thing in.
I tried to use it like a jackal or like a vice to spread the doors. Does it work?
You're not bringing that thing in. You're not going to bring it in.
Roll a strength check using the mech strength, which is +8.
1.
11.
11.
19.
Nope. 25 to break the doors, unfortunately.
Oh,
I don the giant coil ripper.
Fuck.
I'm going to open the door. I'm just going to straight up open the door right away. I understand.
Giant coil ripper.
Can we doll?
Giant coil ripper.
No.
Behave or I will take it away from you, children.
Okay. You're not bringing the mech in. That's it. You're just not bringing the mech in, but you can come in.
I put my mech foot
through. Yes,
he's put his foot in the door.
Go for it. I'll leave. I'm going to go past you then. I'm going to let you do what you're going to do, and I'm going to... How many oxygen tanks are left?
I've got like 4 hours in this thing.
There's still the 6 oxygen tanks in that environment.
I will take all 6.
Okay,
you
so you can
if
add...
your truck had any oxygen?
The buggies do indeed have their own kind of like oxygen supply, very similar to the mechs.
We will jerry-rig that later if need be.
Okay, I'm gonna...
Just because, like, screw it, I'm done.
Yep.
I close the claw of the giant mech suit and using whatever sort of controls. Is it arm-based or is it like joystick?
It's a kind of combination of the both. Like your elbows slide in and you've got joystick controls for like fine maneuvering of the claws.
Okay. So I close the claw and I rotate it. And now that I think about that, that's not going to work. So I open the claw. Rotate, and I'm trying to press the open or release buttons on the other airlock door with the tip of one of the big claw arms. Is that
a
dexterity check?
I am hiding
see
outside.
See if I can open a button.
Vanished.
I'm not surprised you're fucking hiding. I'm not surprised you're fucking hiding.
I'm not stupid, that's why.
Roll. I have no idea what you'd fucking roll.
Are you okay?
No, dude.
He's just like, what the hell is this guy doing? I fully expected this thing to be an enemy. If I can just jump in it and drive it, I'm gonna freaking jump in it and drive it. And I'm gonna drive it right through the end of this campaign.
Well,
roll d20 and add add your intelligence modifier.
I got a 6!
5.
Plus 1 intelligence.
Oh, that's right, you only have 1 intelligence error.
Oh, piss off!
You basically decide that you're going to push the buttons that are the size of human buttons on the control panel using
the
end of...
With a mech fist, yes.
Using a mech fist, which is approximately 8 or 9 inches wide.
Mm-hmm. Hulk smash.
You just tear the whole control mechanism off the wall, leaving
a
sparking wreck. No, the door doesn't open.
Okay, you know what?
Giant coil ripper.
No, I'm driving it. I'm gonna jump into my smaller Will the small buggy fit through here?
No, the small buggy is larger than that, unfortunately.
Okay, I'm going to park the small
you
buggy.
You might want
in front
to get outside.
It. Yeah, I'm already outside. I'm just going to park the small buggy in front of this so that things won't go flying past, mainly him.
Oh, and I want to extend my spike foot.
Okay, so you drive the buggy across the sort of front of the thing. Can I get an intelligence check from both of you?
Oops.
$5, that's a one for me. Oh, 10 plus 2. 12 and...
8.
Should I be nice to you?
Oh God, no. I mean, let's be honest. This is all our fault. This is all his fault. This whole situation is his fault.
I'm gonna say like a series of words and just see if you as players can figure it out. Giant mech, multiple construction tools, metal-sided buggy, unsealable airlock.
Mm-hmm. And my mech is now an immovable object, so it's just getting plowed. Pile drive by all this crap.
Well, no, my point is, like, if you want to create this base sealed, you could weld the side of the buggy to the airlock's outer door. Like, you could essentially weld the buggy in place.
You have a giant welder.
Mm-hmm.
So you could essentially create a fake airlock door by welding the buggy over the door.
Are you going to let me in on this? Are you just thinking about this yourself and going to leave me locked outside?
He's putting something out that we could play with.
Do you want...
In the mindset that Jake Long is currently at...
Yeah.
So at this point, we just got kicked out by the only survivors that we know of because somebody mentioned dead dogs.
Somebody killed
dogs.
I've
had two breakdowns trying to pilot things because of dead dogs. I had somebody refuse to let me in the station, and now I'm sitting here with a giant freaking mech. I finally have power and something that I have control over this time.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not thinking that clearly over my throbbing erection. All the brain from my head has left, and I've got a giant robot erection, and I'm going to pull out my giant coil ripper. That's the mindset my guy's in. It's just like, I finally...
You're pointing out.
Something's in my control, and I know how to use these tools. I'm going to do my job.
Okay. So, Savrik, you're going to hide...
I am outside. I left the buggy there. I'm jumping in the other one and saving my ass.
Okay.
I just think my guy wouldn't be of clear enough mind to be like, oh, hey, I can build this solution.
Okay. You extend the metal pegs into the floor, so it's wedged in the floor, and you get out the giant coil ripper, which is, bearing in mind, your coil ripper is probably about 3 foot long. This thing is more along the lines of like 21 foot long. This thing is massive, and you hold it in both claws of your mech, and you activate it. Your coil ripper, your little coil ripper, kind of sounds a little bit like a large electromagnet, like we would get
like
on
just a humming, like a hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
When it turns on, it kind of goes and then you get the ripping metal sound. This thing sounds a little bit like a light aircraft taking off. Yep. The door just rips apart. Just
erection strengthens.
it's just like Moses parting the Red Sea. It just goes whoop, glowing circle of metal. Roll a pilot check.
No, you're not going to make me do that again.
No, you don't have to do the psychology check. Roll a pilot check.
I'm like, if I think of dead dogs right now, I'm going to die. 17.
Okay, so 21. So you get a flash of that random desperate thought a split second before quite a large number of large crates, small tools, pieces of sharp things impale your unarmored, unprotected body sitting on the front of the construction deck. And you draw both your ripper claws, you draw both your mech claws down in front of your body to protect yourself.
But makes sense, walking halves... with my mechs.
Yep. This only halves the damage you take.
Oh. Shit.
Told you it was a stupid idea.
I still got 4 hours of oxygen. You got like none.
You take 6 damage.
I'm in the buggy. The buggy has its own supply of oxygen.
How long are you going to stay in the buggy?
Until
Psycho Crazy Man's finished.
Yeah, until you're done killing yourself.
Just think, now we can get in, unopposed by anything. And, you know, like, plus there's going to be no zombies because oxygen deprivation and shit.
So,
or I can step on them.
The door has been ripped open. Choices of actions, please.
I step through. I open the door. I'm going to step through it. Like, that's what doors are for.
You open the door. You walk up. Get on the floor. You're going to walk the dinosaur next? Son of a bitch. Okay. No. I'm going to sit in there and ask you, after all that commotion and not noticing if you've moved, because I'm still ducking down, not being an idiot, are you dead yet? That's just the only question. Are you dead? That's all I want to know.
The door is open.
All right, so we have... what? Are you Nike now? Shit. All right.
Just do it! I just love the sigh from Droid. I think that's the first time I've ever heard him sigh like that. See, now this campaign is fun. Got a throbbing robot erection, the DM is broken, and I'm no longer, like, struggling with the pain of dissecting a woman. Now it's fun again.
I thought it was absolutely amazing the entire time.
Well, I was broken. He's like, this is a bad choice. Why are we doing this? Like, I was hurting. Like, you guys will see the video. Like, my face was like, the shit are we... Can I even do this? Like, we've got fictional players on paper. And I'm like, what about Sam? He's so happy there playing his little game. I can't freaking do this. We aren't killing this woman. We aren't zombifying her. Like, right. I had, like, actual... feelings.
So you march your mech into the room, thud, 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 and you look around. There's some cargo containers around. Against the walls, there's some like stacked up cargo containers. There also happens to be 4 evenly spaced devices, is the only thing you can think of. They appear to be. Possibly computer databases, maybe. You're not really sure what they are. Each one of them has seats and interfaces on it. And they're wrapped in heavy metal, in heavy, thick plated metal, and they're bolted into the floor. So you're not really sure what they are.
Mm.
Okay, I'm gonna...
These over here are cargo containers.
Yep.
Thump, 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 thump. I assume he's... Thump, 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 thump. I assume
he... I pick up the cargo container, and because of the width of my mech, I probably destroyed those seats.
Probably,
and
yep.
I'm gonna come back, and one cargo container doesn't quite cover the door, that's it.
Nope.
Okay, I'm going to place one there and start welding it, waiting for Saravok to come in.
Yeah, I kind of see what you're doing. I'm gonna book my ass in there. I'm done hiding. Now that I know everything's either dead or broken to pieces.
I think about sealing things. But it's just like there's something in my way and I've got tools.
Okay.
How long does it take to seal that?
Because
I'm gonna have to go grab another cargo container as well.
probably like 15, 20 minutes of sort of moving cargo containers and probably another 10, 15 minutes of welding them into place to develop a seal that you think is adequate to stop the place instantly degassing when you open doors.
I have 3 oxygen tanks left on me for reference.
Yeah, I think we should open the other airlock and try to repressurize this place.
Yeah, we should open both this one here and this one here so that we can actually get full airflow somewhat restored, or at least marginally better.
Or you know what? We're in a new base. We don't know if this one's reoxygenation system's busted not yet.
Let's try to open the first door,
and then try to hack it to repressurize this area without depressurizing anything else. Because this is a large area to do a thing.
Yeah, but let me test for chemical in the air first, in anything that might be leaking from said cargo containers, you know?
Right, so you're going to use your little Enviro flask. Thermos of environment detection.
I love plus that one. So much.
Yeah.
Greater thermos of environment protection detection plus one. the name's just going to get longer as we play. And it detects the same contamination that you detected in the command bay of the previous station.
Wait. Sorry, I'm just... Something's dawning on me right here. Something that Droid told me the other day during a Discord chat.
Mm.
Yes?
He had 6 maps made up. This is only the 4th that we've seen.
Yes.
We've been playing for 4 hours, or better than 4 hours, and we haven't even done 2 maps. At least last time we did 3 maps.
Why do you think I wanted to go back in there and kill people and go raid everything they had? I want to see more. I want to explore everything. I want this.
And he thought this was going to be like a 2 to 4 hour campaign for the whole thing.
Yeah, this is
someone's
like
greatly underestimating how screwed up we are, or how broken he made us.
I think he's underestimating how deeply involved in my character and your character we've become.
Well, the other stupid thing here is, like, we didn't even make these characters. He just gave us these characters. And we've, like, adopted them as our own.
Yeah.
Okay, like, at this point, I just have to have, like, a big thank you to you, Droid. This has been fantastic.
Yes, you are.
You've almost brought me to tears, like, twice. It's been pretty damn great.
I have.
And
I,
now I've got a throbbing robot erection. Once.
I've cried once, and it was thank you. It was just hilarious, and it was just perfection.
You almost made me, like, turn a chick into a zombie. For science!
I was so down for it, too.
I know, you're such a dick.
Do it for science.
Like, my guy was like, this... Did you not notice that he listed that as his last option of the 4 things that could happen?
Yep.
Like, it was something that was, like, because, at the very, very back of his mind that he's dredging up. And then you're like, hey, let's do this. Yeah, that's a good idea. I thought of that, too. You are so messed up. You are so messed up.
You want to know... When I was waving the other flesh over it, the infected dead flesh, that's what I was seeing for, noticing if there was any reaction. And I was going to do somewhat similar with not mine, but, you know, Darren's uninfected flesh, or relatively as far as we knew, and do that, and then work my way up to something I knew was uninfected, such as myself. But you just went right ahead and went, I'm going to melon ball myself, because screw everything. I'm not going to say shit.
I'm like, am I infected? This is so messed up. Is it affecting me? That was my concern. I'm like, fuck this, am I a zombie?
I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna logic this way. I'm going to logic my way through it. I'm dismembering people. Oh,
Droid's just waiting here to say something. Like, I hear him breathing, he's like, he has something weigh in on us. And we're just talking over him at this point. Okay, so what's up, Droid?
Okay, so you wave your greater improved flask of environment detection.
Oh, we're
plus
still
one.
On that?
Yeah. I guess so.
And you detect the same kind of contamination that was in the command bay. While the command bay had a contamination level of about 2 on the device, about 2 marks, because it's a very simple device. This one has filled all 10 marks. This is as contaminated in as the air could get with this particular contaminant, although the machine doesn't understand exactly what this particular contaminant is.
Okay.
Damn, I didn't ask Sam if it could become airborne or not, whether it was just by contact. I did ask him that.
This have a... If I move closer to the location where it's emanating from, would it give off a sound, some sort of notification, or does Jake have the machine that has some sort of other...
No, I just got something that senses vibrations.
Yeah, that's... I was going to say, let's use that.
Moving towards contamination might have worked to give you a location of contamination source if it wasn't already maxed out. It's essentially okay. reading off chart now, so you can't okay. read like
it is.
The other thing is I just depressed the place, which would have sucked everything everywhere. And then now because there's no atmosphere in here, everything's just kind of like stagnant and sitting where it is. It's not like wafting through an atmosphere.
It went for about 15 minutes, so anything that was previously in here that is not leaking from one of said containers is... So it is emanating from this room or from the ventilation, which could be running through this area. I suggest we get out of your suit, open up this airlock. We don't search anything in here. We don't have the time currently until we're sure that this won't kill us.
What are you talking about? I got 4 hours in this thing.
Okay, but I'd rather not search this place alone because I only have about another hour total.
Let's check out the computer, see what we can find out. Like, we got the super armored computers.
Okay, I'm gonna, I'll plug in the network interface and attempt to...
I take it I can't actually access those with mech, so...
No, you can't.
Let's jump out into a seat.
Okay, so both you and Savrok, both Jake and Savrok, jump out of whatever they're doing, and they go over to these big armored devices, these big armored sort of semi-circular things coming up out of the ground, and they both interface with them. So give us some computer use checks.
Wow, saddest roll. At least it's not a two.
Oh,
he critically examines that thing.
Right. So, with your critical computer use skill, what are you trying to do to it? To this device that you're examining?
Shit, what was it? What was said earlier? We got on the Sony of the things, and I can't remember what the hell it was I said earlier when I was using this originally. Find out a way to, if everything else is contaminated, or essentially what happened here, if it's on any of the system logs, if we can fix the whole oxygen situation. If the oxygen circulation system is up and running. There you go.
Okay. So you log into the computer and you start searching through the computer and you find out that the computer you are logged into is essentially isolated from the network. The computer you're logged into has some scientific research logs associated with it, and an awful lot of information. We're talking about like this computer you're logged into is like Encyclopedia Britannica times 1,000. This like you are digging through ream after ream of file, and the odd thing is it all seems to be calculation based. It all seems to be an awful lot of rapidly done calculations. However, digging through, you do find a command, which is basically an inspection command, a command for engineers to inspect inspect the computer.
I'll use that. Let's do that.
Okay.
I want to inspect. Yeah.
What was that?
What was that?
Well,
that roll of two.
Yeah. I tried that two. I'm gonna own that two. That's my two, and I rolled it, and I rolled it good. Fuck you two.
What was the two for?
Well, that as he's been looking at the computer, and like I sat down at the computer and punched some keys, and I couldn't do dick. Like, where's the login screen? Because I rolled so low. I've been looking around the crates, and then I was going to run a spot check to see if there's anything I looked at other than, like, because I've been taking time, I was hoping that I would have seen labels on crates and then whatever else I would have seen with a freaking spot check, but apparently my spot check is 3 after my modifier, or 2 after my, or 4 after my modifier, so yeah. So, I saw crates.
Yeah, yay. You saw crates. Big shiny crates made of metal.
So as I've been taking time here, would I have noticed any to do because like I actually am taking time slowly going around as he's doing his computer shit?
So basically, as he's doing his computer shit,
is there any labels through that?
Crates. There's not many labels, but you do manage to pop a few crates. An awful lot of it is chemicals. Some of it is food. Some of it is construction components. But like 90% of the crates contain glass chemical jars like the ones you saw in the docking bay at the original base. Savarik pushes the engineer's inspect, expecting a panel to pop open so that maybe he could access this computer device. When he activates the engineer's inspect mode on this particular computing device printed bolted to the floor, bearing in mind this is like a 20-foot by 15-foot by 30-foot computer device, there is a loud clang and a sort of like a chugging of a motor, and the armored panels start to peel back.
Okay.
Like, I go to look inside as this groove is opening.
And underneath these glass panels, or underneath these metal armored panels, is big panels of glass set into a frame. And inside these big panels of glass set into a frame are long crystals looking a lot like quartz crystals. And they are coated in a kind of organic mass that is wrapped around the crystal. And jabbed into the organic mass are long metal rods periodically jabbed into the organic material that is wrapped around these crystals. And the whole thing is just pulsing.
Shit.
Are they like tightly pressed in there, or is it like a filled thing where there's some movement that could happen to the gel or the organic mass?
Originally from like the looks of it, it was probably designed to be suspended in a kind of a free space. But the organic mass has expanded to pretty much fill the area that that's available.
Okay,
I'm gonna inspect this a little bit further.
Yeah, I'll check it, but I'm not gonna do anything to it.
Sweet, I got a 19.
Oh,
my, inspecting this further, and you got a 20. What?
I got a nat 20 and a 9 for my spot check bonus. Oh shit.
So, to be honest, like, there's not a huge amount more to see. You can see, like, that,
Oh, come on, the only time we roll awesome, it's like, well, I already described everything, like, it's gel-filled plates, guys, like, come on.
Okay, is it organic material similar to the, Edward dog, whatever you want to call it, the Fullmetal Alchemist?
You asshat, don't bring that up right now.
Edward.
You know, like that sort of thing.
It bears a resemblance to the amorphous blob living in the tank back at the other base. It also bears a resemblance to the kind of sort of like bulbous growth that you found on the person in the hydroponics bay.
Is any of it spilling over from any of the cells that we can see? Like you say, it's expanded. It seems to have expanded if we look at it from its original suspended state. Does it look like it's overflowing anywhere?
The whole thing is like a sealed container that was covered with metal, but the container itself is sealed. It seems to have expanded to pretty much fill the container almost all the way, but you can't see anywhere where it's ruptured the container's body.
All right, what do you think? What do you want to do with this? I suggest we leave it alone and favor of trying to access this panel on these set of doors and check out the arrow,
you're
check
already
out
in the computer
oxygen.
You're already in the computer. Do a search for organic neural networks and self-replicating self-replicated non-symmetrical or non-centralized neural interfaces. for neural networks.
Okay, yeah, so, I'll do a search for that.
So Savrik accesses the computer system and starts using terms that were given to you by Samuel back in the med bay before he went completely fucking nuts.
Oh wait, shit. Are we still in range of Samuel? Like, could we radio him?
You could try, but like, your suit radios aren't necessarily designed for long-range communication.
Well, I'm just wondering at this point, like, he's beat the freaking game because he's zoned in there, and he's like, what do I do with my time now? Oh, right, somebody was talking about a science experiment. I'm a science dude, and he's, like, zombified the bitch.
Oh.
Like, yeah, how fucked up would that be?
I mean,
Can I boost my radio with the, with the truck?
You could boost your radio with the,
Or with the mech? I'm already here with the mech.
You could boost your radio with the buggies outside.
Shit, I welded us in here.
Yeah, you did.
So Savrik,
that's going to be like weighing on me all day now. Or yeah. I guess all night. I was like, I'm going to have dreams about Samuel just all happy there playing his freaking tower defense game, and then like, I'm done. I beat it. Level 99 finished. Woohoo! Oh!
No.
Right, those guys were talking about that. Let's science this shit. And then she's just, like, sobbing to herself and not caring and just going along with it. And then, like, slowly zombifying as he's, like, infecting her.
Yes, but first, you have to imagine he's cutting off her hands with a hacksaw and
shut
a smile
the fuck
on his
up.
Face.
Shut the fuck up. You are sick. You are sick.
And he's smiling the entire time.
if we fast forward or rewind from this moment back to where we are now, Savrik is sitting at the computer. You and Jake have a little discussion, and you start to feed in words that Samuel gave you. So you feed in a non-centralized neural network, and up comes a ream of information about the principle of organic beings with non-centralized neural networks being able to essentially move with limbs missing, or limbs being able to move when they're cut off the creature. Huge amounts of information about the principle of non-centralized neural networks being used for colony-style information exchange, and even the idea of distinct individuals with non-centralized neural networks making a colony style, like a beehive of increased intelligence, because they all exchange information, and the non-centralized neural network is specifically designed for this information exchange that then leads to greater intelligence.
A hive mind.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, something just nagged at the back of my mind. While he's still going through his computer, I want to throw the vibro sensor on the floor and see what I hear.
Okie dokie.
Vibro sensor thing. Yes.
If you have a think about the next thing you'd like to throw into the search engine, I'll tell Toad what his vibro sensor picks up. And his vibro sensor picks up basically a couple of different things. You pick up a background hum, which you presume is the station. You pick up a low rhythmic thumping, and right at the very back, you pick up an intermittent, too high for human hearing, random period buzz.
Shit, it's still there. I was hoping we left that behind in the station. It's like, there's still that thing. I hadn't thought about it in so long, but there's still that high-pitched buzz.
Do a search for system-wide or station-wide decontamination.
You type in station-wide decontamination.
Again, you're searching in an encyclopedia, dude. You aren't searching in a networked computer.
Let's just see what comes up. So he puts in system-wide decontamination or station-wide decontamination. He does get back some encyclopedia-style entries about why system and station-wide decontamination systems exist in science. Then the screen goes blue. Then the screen goes black. Then the words, "Why do you want to kill me?" appear on the screen.
I throw an acid bomb in the bitch.
Nope.
The thing's open. We've got three more to deal with. I'm throwing an acid bomb inside of the computer.
Don't quite think it's that simple. You're going to disable
I don't care. I'm freaking the fuck out. The computer's talking to us now like the Dogman Gumby Pillsbury Doughboy was.
Okay.
I'm done.
I go to the dive.
Like, I just see your screen flickers with why do you want to kill me? And I'm just like, nope, you're dead.
Nope.
You can't can't scream at me. I'm not walking away from this one freaking out and tunnel visioning. You're dead.
I'm dive tackling you. I'm not having this because you're gonna cause
me. Did we do an initiative or did I just like throw a thing in there?
Like you have to draw
fair,
your.
Like, what's my missile? My missile is 9, so I got an 18.
So again, I'm gonna ask you guys: I going to be nice or am I going to be horrible?
You're going to be real. Just what happens?
Okay, so because you're sitting at the computer and you are basically like you are looking at the screen, you are facing the computer, you're on a seat, your legs are under a desk, there is no way you'd be able to get up before he pulls an acid bomb off his waist, turns it on and chucks it.
Okay.
So he pulls an acid bomb off his waist, turns it on and tosses it the full 5 foot against this computing device, against this thing.
Well, I was hoping to aim inside the crack because like it's opened up like a big clamshell.
Well, it's the metal armor's open.
Yeah,
up, but
it's still
said,
covered
it's
in glass. That's why I was like,
oh, so I've just thrown it against glass.
Yeah, thank you.
Wow,
that's what I said.
I should have listened to that description better.
Yeah,
roll
2d8,
please.
Son of a bitch.
2d8.
But I get both ones. So I'm gonna just shoot you in the goddamn leg.
13.
13. The hardness on the glass is 8. You do 5 damage to the glass. The glass has 6 hit points. A massive great crack spreads across the glass, but it does not yet shatter.
Wait, so is this... So I was assuming, like, when this opened up and you were giving the description, that there was, like, isolinear chips type thing from Star Trek railed in this thing in, like, series? Like, sandwiched with stuff? This is just one big glass jar of brain, matter, crap, whatever.
He said it encased in glass.
Return to the original description. The metal plates peel back, and inside is glass panels connected together to form a large tank. In this tank is suspended several big crystals of quartz-like substance, and wrapping around these crystals is organic matter that seems to have...
Yeah, so when you say glass panels with crystals in it, I'm like, okay, like a glass shield with crystals filled with organic stuff, and then it would be like series of chips, but no, I was completely wrong. Okay, so I just... So, yeah, okay.
Think more along the lines of, do you know the Spice Masters from Dune?
Okay, yes.
So think more along the lines of Spice Masters from Dune.
Okay.
So now it has a massive great crack across the side of it.
And the
and I shoot it with my holdout pistol.
That's two actions.
Yeah, that's two actions. He does get to take actions before you now.
Son of a bitch.
We've got a computer talking to us as if it is a knowledgeable being, and I'm freaking the hell out. You are not freaking the hell out after space zombies and, you know, the talking dog thing that you've tried to kill but missed because you were so screwed up, I'm assuming, that you couldn't shoot it twice.
We've already dealt with so much terrible shit that I'm expecting.
What, you're acclimatized to it now?
This is not as terrible as a screaming dog-like thing who's just asking to be killed.
This one's worse. This one is actually conversing with you after intercepting a query put into a computer.
Yep. I much prefer that to something that is screaming at me in what I assume
to
be...
Whatever, take your action. Do your thing.
Toad's done.
I'm just gonna get up and shoot you in the goddamn leg.
Me and Jake Long
are
scared shitless.
I'm just shooting you. I'm shooting you in the leg.
Wait, what?
You stupid ass. Yeah, I'm shooting you in the leg. You almost killed me with the acid bomb. I'm shooting you in the leg.
I didn't even come close. I threw it in a computer.
Which I was sitting at.
At like the far end of it.
It's within splash damage range. Nope. Shooting you in the leg.
You didn't even have to do a will save or reflex save on that. Come on, you weren't even close.
Your attack bonus is plus 4 for ranged weapons. Plus 7. Sorry, that's your right reflex saver. Plus 7 for ranged weapons. So you get a 17.
Do I have to do a reflex on that?
No. This is your armor class that's defending you. And your armor class is 18 as far as I'm aware. So he misses.
Armor class
just
19.
He misses. Just
nonetheless, misses. The thought was what counts, you jackass. And I'm just going to kind of go this way away from you and your idiocy, which is going to eventually get me and most likely everyone else killed. You have done nothing at all that has not almost gotten me killed every time. Let's open up the airlock doors. Let's open up the airlock doors with a giant ass coral ripper and not worry about the consequences. Shit. You absolute.
You only mentioned two things. I've done a lot more actions than that.
I know. I'm saying you've nearly killed me at least 5 times. At least.
So, Sandrock pulls his pistol and discharges it at Jake's leg. Misses. The shot goes wide. As he marches off, he walks past another one of these computing devices with its armor still in place. The screen flickers on as he walks past the screen. And the message appears on the screen, which the language is a little bit garbled. It's a slightly kind of inelegant way of saying things, but basically it's a query asking how something called Ira is. It's kind of asking after Ira.
I'm gonna sit down and type Ira? In. I don't know what Ira is.
Like Ira, like a name or like error?
Ira, yeah, how is it? I R A.
Okay.
Like the Irish Republican Army, is that what it's asking about? Because I don't think that's been relevant for a very long time.
Savrick sits down and types in, "I don't know what Ira is," and it replies with, "Ira is my brother."
Okay.
And you don't want to blow these things up yet?
Nope. I'm going to ask what its brother looks like, or rather.
Okay. So you've left a computer terminal completely on, asking, "Why are you trying to kill me?" I'm going to walk up to the terminal that you've left on and you've unlocked for me, so I don't have to do any shit about this. Because I'm just typing on a keyboard, and I can still do that. I believe so. Do I have to roll anything, droid?
No, you can type away.
Yay! What the fuck are you? That's what I type.
It responds.
I'm just freaking out. And I already tried to blow it up once, so.
Savrock is typing into his saying he doesn't know what the brother looks like. He's asking what the brother looks like, and Blaster Toad is saying, "What the hell are you?" Blaster Toad's computer replies with, "I am Ira. I am process." And Savrock's screen replies with, "He looks like me. He is my brother."
Okay. I'm gonna ask. Is it the one that's? Is it the terminal that my ass clown is typing into currently, or?
please type that in. I want to know the computer's response to. Is it the one that my ass clown's typing into?
That's legitimately how just choked I am at you right now. In character, I'm calling you an ass clown to a sentient computer who has no idea what is going on. This is how much of a knob gobbler you are. You absolute penis fiend.
So Savrick's computer responds to, is it the one my ass clown is typing at with, what is ass clown? Blaster Toad, are you going to type anything to your computer?
The passive aggressiveness.
I could totally white girl right now and just be like, I can't even.
Okay. While he's sitting there being a silent.
Tell me I have no ass. Give me a pumpkin spice latte, and I can't even. Like, I'm that white girl right now.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm gonna ask my computer if it's the one that by ass town I'm referring to the other human in the room with me typing into the other terminal. If that terminal is said brother.
So you ask it if it is the terminal being typed at by the other human being, and if that's the brother, to which it responds is, what is human?
Okay. I type Savage. Into my computer, what external interfaces do you possess?
It replies with external interface is disallowed. Terminal interface is allowed.
Okay, so terminal only then.
I'm gonna ask if it has any connection to anything outside itself. Outside.
That's what I just asked.
No. If it has any knowledge, like any ability to communicate with the next to it.
You basically ask if it's able to communicate with anything, to which it responds, communication along the lines of communication was allowed, communication is banned, I am lonely.
So it just answered the same thing. I asked if it had external interface.
You know, yeah, but you type that. I don't know any of this shit.
All right, yeah. Freaking disassociation of characters here. Okay.
I want to ask if it knows the layout of this room. Does it know where it is in relation to its brother?
It replies with basically it brings up a schematic of the station, which includes basically the map you can see now. And a large open cavern off to the right-hand side. It highlights that in the room you're in, there are four of these creatures, four of these things, and it names them. And it has Ira.
What? I lost her connection.
Oh, freaky.
This thingy died again.
No,
the,
it just
straight up said. Doesn't like him.
No, it straight up said you lost connection to server. That's it. That was weird. But go on, I'm listening intently.
It has brought up this schematic and it labels the four computers. Apparently you're sitting at the computer called Ora. You have the computer behind you, which is called Ara. You have the computer behind Toad, which is called Era. And you have the computer Toad is sitting at, which is called Ira.
Okay. Try us again.
Okay. So the reason I rolled there was I want to do a spot check or computer knowledge check, whichever one works best for me or whatever I need. And my intent is to look around the computer, look for some sort of network access or see if the network lines have been cut to it, seeing if there's a way I can reconnect it to network.
Oh, okay.
not quite what you were expecting, apparently.
Nope. You go hunting around, leaving the computer where it is. You go hunting around, you find that these things have obviously been moved and they've obviously been installed here. There are some markings that suggest that certain parts of the machinery attached to the chambers has been removed and replaced with blank shells. Because of this, you assume that like the networking cards, the data adaption cards have been removed. The best thing you can assume is that if you could find a computer with a decent data interface adaption card, you could probably rip off one of the terminals and probably jury rig through a circuit board, some kind of network connection.
Okay, while he's doing that, I'm gonna inform the current computer being with which I'm dealing with that it's Brother Ira is the glass case is damaged, but it is absolutely fine otherwise.
Ah, I see.
Okay, so you're just gonna go tell a computer that is of unknown intelligence and whatever,
I
and
didn't
you don't
say
know its
you
powers.
It.
You're just saying,
I did not,
yeah,
I did not
your brother's kind of fucked up right now, but otherwise he's okay.
I did not state that we damaged it. I stated upon which we the situation, which currently is.
Yeah, you also
I'm not
just
say, it has
very
no...
innocently gave a broken woman a picture of her like significant other, which caused her completely flip the hell out.
Okay, so Savrik's computer responds with, this is a relief. It detected explosion, concern for brother. Brother is okay. And then it pops up a couple of dots, and then it pops up glass broken, and it says that Chirichira, be angry. It suggests that something called Chirichira is going to be angry because the glass is broken.
Okay, I'm just gonna straight out ask who, or rather, what that is, and if it has any. Yeah, just what is it? Where is it? And yeah, just what? Because I already know. I remember that. I have that written on my sheet from elsewhere. The previous shenanigans.
Okay, so
as he's asking I'm gonna walk by, ask what he's found, and also start heading towards the mech.
Okay, so as Blaster Toad or as Jake Long walks past, and as Savrik is asking this question about what Chirichira is, the computer simply responds with it's about a 48 page document, but the first page of the document is essentially a full body photograph of the middle aged woman with black hair with grey roots who pointed a pistol at you in the airlock. What follows is a complete kind of like biological history that includes the names of her parents, her date of birth, her entire job history, her education history, and kind of finishes up with the fact that she is the senior research manager of Station 11583.
Which is this station, I am going to assume from... Okay. I'm now going to fill you in on what I just found out.
And like I'm up in the mech currently looking for radio communications components, see if there's anything I can hack off here.
All right, so the black-haired woman who showed you her tits is going to die. That's just...
Wait, what?
I'm just going to... Yeah, I'm just stating that she is in charge of operations here and seemingly knows what is going on. And is the cause of it, at least as far as I can tell.
You're reading a lot into whatever you just learned.
There's a 48-page document, and I was informed that Chirichira is her, or rather,
whatever,
you know, whatever
she is.
I'm going
to take you at face value, whatever you said. Except for I know you're a sneaky bastard, and only half listen to you.
So, Blaster Toad does manage to find some radio communications equipment that would probably work to jury-rig a network connection. What the fuck's he gonna do?
Yeah, I know. Okay, I'm just gonna get up and just leave it at that. I'm just done with the crazy talking computer for now.
This one's still decompressed, right?
Yeah, and I'm gonna...
Yeah. I'm gonna jump back in the mech to refill my suit oxygen.
Okie dokes.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna open this airlock up.
And I yell at you to stop.
The first airlock entrance. I'm opening that up and stepping inside and closing it. Just no.
Okay, so Savrik's gone through the airlock.
I'm just staying in here. That's it. I'm just informing you I'm staying here just because I don't trust you.
He's just locked himself in an airlock. Yeah. Blaster Toad has hold of network connection devices.
I could probably only make one network card with this, eh?
Probably only one network card, yeah.
Start cutting a man-sized hole over here. In the hole I just sealed, I know.
Okay, so you start cutting your way through the 10-foot deep crates of chemicals that you've welded over the doorframe.
So what's that, like 3, 4, 6? How many things do I got to go through to get through that?
They're not particularly thick crates.
Yeah,
so
I'm just
going to
move all this shit out of the way.
Four magnetic coil rounds to get through them. But like moving the glass bottles full of chemicals isn't really an option. You're just breaking glass bottles full of chemicals now.
Nice.
I'm opening up this airlock.
I'm going for more radios.
Just
going
to step through. I'm just stepping through.
Going for more radios. Fucking
I'm
hell.
I'm stepping inside the airlock and I'm just going to... What do I see in here?
Okay, so while Toad is cutting his way out and grabbing some more radios because apparently...
I'm hiding.
Determined to reduce the world to a smoking crater by unleashing hyper-intelligent computers on everything. fucking hell.
Yeah.
You come into a small room that contains some basically like storage lockers. They're like personnel lockers. There's quite a few personnel lockers in here. Most of them don't have names on, but you see a couple of names. You see Kim Lo and Corbin and Amanda and Chirachira and Derek and a couple of other sort of names dotted around. But most lockers are blank. You also see smears of like organic matter across the walls. It doesn't look like the organic matter from the tank. It's kind of like a dark green color. And there are also quite distinct holes in the walls, possibly from high-power military rounds from rifles.
All right. No zombies of any sort in here. I am currently safe physically from harm.
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to pull out my chemical detection thermos. Is it safe in this airlocked room?
So the chemical detection furnace is detecting huge amounts of contamination of the same stuff that you have detected before, but that contamination when you went into the command bay didn't seem to do you any harm. It is much higher here, but there doesn't seem to be anything else wrong. There is oxygen in the atmosphere, there is nitrogen in the atmosphere, there's not an excess of CO2 in the atmosphere. Theoretically you could breathe.
But we don't know what the contaminant is.
Nope.
Yeah, I'm gonna expend another oxygen tank, drop down to 2, and
okay.
I'm gonna rip through these lockers and find what I can find.
Searching people's lockers.
I'm gonna collect all the oxygen tanks I can that are in here.
Okay, so you start searching for oxygen tanks, and then meanwhile Jake Long is rigging up.
I'm going to pull the 2 other radios out of the trucks.
Okay.
Okay. I don't have to go to the trucks, do I? Are all the suit lockers full? Like,
yes.
Is there suits?
Yes.
I've got 6 radios right here. I'm going to take all those radios.
Okay.
Okay. Being a military base, have I noticed any cameras around?
Never said it was a military base. I said it had a military-style lockdown.
Okay.
But
like the other base had surveillance equipment. Does this base have surveillance equipment?
As far as you can tell, no.
Damn it. The trucks, would it be audio only, or would it be audio-video communications that they had in them?
They would probably have some kind of audio visual communication system.
Okay, so as I rip out these 6 radios, my next action would be to go out and pull a camera out of one of the trucks.
Okay.
You sound confused.
I am.
Okay.
But I'm gonna go with this.
How many oxygen tanks do I find?
Zero.
Son of a bitch. Okay. What else do I find in this room then?
You find some uniforms. You find an awful lot of empty lockers. You find some basic sort of notepads and some bits and pieces. It's pretty much empty, to be fair. Like this okay. This particular locker room seems pretty much like it's got nothing useful in it.
All right. I am going to test move my helmet for 15 seconds, see what the situation is, how difficult it is to breathe, if difficult at all, and what adverse effects it has on me.
Okie dokie, so you pop open your helmet and roll a fortitude save. Okay, so you pop open your helmet and you take a breath and it hurts, but it hurts like breathing in frigid air would hurt. It hurts like you've just stuck your head in a freezer and inhaled deeply. But as far as you can tell, like, it's not instantly killed you.
Okay.
That's a good thing.
Okay, I'll leave my helmet off and be the guinea pig, I guess. It's seemingly safe.
Okay.
And so we have one person. Yet, or am I still scavenging stuff?
You don't take particularly too long to grab what you want from the things. You can come back. And what would you like to do with these things?
I've got I just like to, six, seven radios currently, and a camera. I had a plan.
Now, before
for
you
this,
do anything,
swear.
I'm just gonna let you know that it is safe to breathe in here so far, but I don't know about the out there situation. You might just, you know, die instantly. So far, I'm not dead. It's all good so far.
Okay.
Okay.
So what was Toad going
to
do?
Era. I swear I had a plan like 15 seconds ago. I was doing a thing. I was collecting this for a reason.
I love the fact that you asked me, was I confused? And I was like, yes. And then he's like, I have no idea what I'm doing. That's why I'm confused.
Okay. And typing back into the terminal. Have you ever had a body?
The era replies with, I have body.
Have you ever had locomotion?
Locomotion is transient.
Do you possess locomotion?
Locomotion could be acquired.
If locomotion was provided, would you help provider of locomotion? Or assist provider of locomotion?
It takes a little while to respond. It sort of like ticks through for a couple of seconds. It responds with, what is help?
Would you provide assistance? Provider or wording this to a damn computer. Frickin' hell, I wanted to blow you up a second ago.
A couple of seconds pass and the computer responds with.
Oh, go ahead.
A couple of seconds pass and the computer responds with, do you mean trade?
Trade is a sufficient analogy. Typed into computer.
Okay, so the computer takes a few seconds, then it replies with, trade for locomotion, acceptable.
Okay, and then, what is computer's view of small locomotive animals, or mammals?
What the fuck have you got in mind?
Reference humans. I'm trying to see if it's harmful to us, if it's malicious.
Ah, right. Okay, so you ask what its opinion of humans are, and what its opinion of humans is, and it replies with human mass acceptable, human mass low, intelligent quotient limited, human mass useful, drone work.
Fuck that shit, my plan's out the window. Okay. Locomotion no longer option for trade. Network connection option for trade. Network connection to current station location. Unlock bypass doors. Question mark.
Trade. Network connection for door access. Agreeable.
I build up one network card and try to jury-rig something into a terminal on the station.
Craft electronics, please.
While he's doing that, I'm gonna do the same thing I did. Come back out here and just chill on the Mac and get some breath back.
Okay, so you burn through one of your three communication cards. Try again.
Because, yeah, I only had a 9 on that roll with fire. Okay, that works better.
On your second attempt, you managed to rig ERA into the terminal, and ERA gets connection to the station network. The screens on ERA's computer light up with huge amounts of data, digital coding, thousands upon thousands of screens of digital coding flickering past second by second with ridiculous speed. And then all the lights go off and all the doors go open.
Okay. I'm over here in the mech.
Oh, okay. I
moved my ass back and got here like a smart person.
Can you get out of the mech for a second? I would like to re-grab some oxygen.
Yeah, there's no lights at all. No, you have a whole bunch of oxygen tanks. I have 2.
No, I don't. I didn't grab any. I searched for them.
Oh,
you grabbed all 6 out of there.
Okay.
I'm gonna refill my oxygen.
Okay.
Okay, so. Okay. I'm gonna.
Back at the
I have
computer
this
now. Do you understand death, or do you comprehend death?
Death possibility, death unlikely. Network connection grants immortality.
What is connection outside of station or current facility?
Connection outside of station, current facility, freedom, improvement.
Okay, so I'm just reading this over your shoulder.
Question mark.
What'd you say?
Connection established? Question mark. Like, does it have that freedom connection, or would that be the outcome if it had the connection? Like, is there a radio connection currently from the station elsewhere?
It takes a couple of rephrasings before the computer understands what you're asking. But it finally responds with freedom currently unavailable. Freedom trade?
Freedom not trade? Or does not equal trade or whatever. Or whatever, but negative acknowledgement.
Okay.
You said out of the 6 hit points, I brought this thing down by 5 or 4?
The glass you brought down by 4. The glass has 1, 5, sorry. Your glass has 1 hit point left.
Okay. Query to terminal. If casing destroyed, what is status of current interfacing operator? So the computer.
Okay, so casing destroyed, ERA exposed vacuum, damage not irretrievable.
Not irretrievable. Okay.
Okay,
Well, do-do-do-do-do.
Go ahead, Savrak. What's Savrak up to?
I'm thinking. I'm standing over his shoulder, just looking at what was being said. I'm just going to suggest that you sort of stop what you're doing now.
I want to take one of my acid bombs because I still have. How many do I got left?
You still have one acid bomb left, and
Oh, I only had two. Yes. Okay.
Yeah, and you
and
have
one smoke grenade.
two because he only threw the one.
Yeah.
He used
Great.
the one to,
Okay.
just like you have one acid bomb and one two grenades left.
Would I be able to just sit and take time to, with a radio connection, craft a remote explosive out of my existing acid bomb, or would I have to roll a check?
You could, using your existing acid bomb, quite easily create a timed detonation.
Timed it, but can with the radios I've scavenged, because I've still got out of my six, seven, I still got five left. Could I do use two of those to make a remote connection?
You could, but you would have to roll, and if you got below a five, the acid bomb would blow up in your face. Because you would have accidentally connected things that were live.
I'm going to back up.
Okay,
Yeah, 14.
so you create a remote detonation acid bomb.
Query to computer, do you recognize this operator? Referring to myself or some sort of phrasing like that. Basically, like, do you recognize myself and the authority I have as I have given you access to terminal or access to network? Or like can it monitoring myself that? Actually, yeah, let's phrase it that way. Can you monitor current mammalian operators? So the two
Monitor
humans in the room.
query. Details required.
Okay. Do-do-do-do. Is there an external interface to track moving targets as designated by current location?
Track all moving objects within base. Vibration sensors active.
Oh.
Perfect. Do-do-do. Okay, so I don't want to go through like the whole computer speak trying to make this thing understand me, so I'll let you do a
Okay.
bunch of rephrasings for me. But the gist of my conversation with this is you've told me that your casing, if damage exposed, would expose yourself and would not be preferable. There is
Okay.
a remote explosive. Tag the two vibrations you're sensing in this room as living creatures. Mark them as friendly or essential. And if any harm is to come to these two targets, then casing would be damaged and ear would be exposed via remote explosive. Please warn
Okay.
us of anything that would be of danger in our path, anything that may be of threat to current flagged essential targets, and anything moving or causing vibration in the path of current set targets as flagged essential. So basically,
Oh.
allow us to know what's in our path, or I fucking kill you, Robo
Okay.
bitch.
Okay. Yep. So you've left your Soniscan on the floor, and your Soniscan's been just happily pinging away, and you can feel and hear through the floor that, and you can even notice that, like certain electronics on the base are now flickering. The lights come on for a second, go off again. Come on for a second, go off again, very, very rapidly, and all of this creates vibration that the Soniscan's picking up. Then that periodic kind of random background, higher than human hearing vibration, suddenly becomes almost consistent, almost constant for about 40, 50 seconds, and then peters back down to the periodic little flicker and buzz that it gives. And with all the lights off, the screen pops up, the message that deal agreed, basically.
Fuck, them thinking is the high-pitched sound.
Yep. That's, yeah. Okay.
Possibly.
So there the thing.
Doors are open, lights are off. How bad is the visibility in here?
Are the lights still off, or did you just say, or, yeah, you never said they came back on?
They flickered on and off for a few seconds, but they're still off. They flickered on and off, and that created a lot of sort of sonic vibrations that your sonic scan picked up on. And then after that, the background high-pitched sonic increased dramatically and then tapered off again.
So it might just be something light-sensitive in here.
So how is the visibility, though? Is it, with my cybernetic eye, can I see pretty...
With your cybernetic eye, you've got about 60 foot of vision. So you can see reasonably well. It's in monochrome, it's not in color, but you can see reasonably well for 60 foot in any direction, which is 12 squares. Blastitoad, unfortunately, is reduced to about 20 foot of vision using the shoulder mounted torch on his spacesuit.
All right.
I request from the computer for lights to be turned on since it's now a network.
Lights inaccessible, power required, processing improved.
I am going to roll to hide. I'm going to roll to hide.
Okay.
I'm going to go grab more oxygen from the mech so I'm fully suited up again.
That's the wrong dice. I am handicapped. Wow. Not even close to the right one. Jeez. There you go.
Shouldn't we have had to roll up save or something, like when it opened all the frickin' doors as a decompression?
There was no decompression when it opened the doors.
So the rest of the base was not compressed?
Possibly.
But he went in this room and he had oxygen.
He did.
The shit? Because I cut a hole through this door, this area, to access those suits. This is completely open.
Yes.
He cycled this airlock and he had breathable atmosphere in here. There should have been some sort of, if not minor, decompression.
There should have.
But there wasn't for some reason, of which we will find out. Also, with my hide skill, I got 16.
So you're 16 points worth of hidden. You're harder to spot than you should be.
I've got a robot keeping track of all our movements and supposed to be telling us if we're got danger ahead.
It's supposed to be.
If we come into any danger, I'm going to blow the bitch. So I just walk nonchalantly out to here.
Okay, so you have not come against anything yet. There's some crates full of chemicals. And then as you go around the corner, there's three sets of shelves, and on these sets of shelves are racks of little quartz-like crystals. Okay. Roughly about the size of a soda can.
Walked about here. Hey.
All right. Seeing as how I've got the 60-foot vision, that's
Since the computer is networked, would I be able to reach it on my radio or no?
You could try, but it's networked into the station. As far as you asked it, the station doesn't have radio communication, so it's got no freedom.
Shit, how is it supposed to tell us if there's issues in front of us?
Yeah, why do you think I'm hiding?
I'm gonna run back to the computer.
Okay.
Yeah,
It with another set of radios, a external interface that can broadcast short-range radio with the suit radios.
Okay, give it a
what
go.
What do I see in here?
You see an awful lot of boxes full of rubble, and Blastitoad blows out two radios of the six he has.
And...
he manages to rig up a radio connection with the computer.
Now we're down to four radios.
Okay.
Oh, right, so I was going to give it an eye so it could see us. That's why I grabbed the camera.
Oh, God, he was making fucking howl. Christ.
Yeah. Now I remember my plan. I was going to give it an eye to watch us, and then I wanted to hook it up to the, when I said, well, fuck that, my plan's out the window, because it said, it would make... humans, drones, they're useful. I was going to see if I could have it follow behind us in the mech suit as like the RoboCat.
No.
And then network the four of them together. That's why I grabbed all the freaking radios. But then as soon as it said that, I'm like, no, screw that. That's a bad idea. Oh, how awesome God. Would that have been, though, if it like didn't want to like turn us into slave workers?
So in this room, there are large crates, steel crates full of rubble, basically.
Okay, that's it. All right. I'm going to slowly make my way through.
Yep.
To the opposite side. This airlock here. It's open now, okay. But it's...
Yep. They're all unlocked.
Okay.
You can go through if you want.
Okay.
I'm
going to
go slow.
Saravok.
Here.
Saravok, on the radio. Freaking dude.
Yep.
Should I follow or flank to the left?
Follow.
And radio bitch and see if there's anything causing vibrations in our immediate vicinity room areas. Did I just, even though I crafted with an 18 skill, I fucked that up?
Oh, no.
Oh right, it has no verbal communications.
This is what I'm wondering, what are you doing the entire time? I'm still hiding.
Single click for yes, double click for no. Is there vibrations in the immediate room vicinities?
Yes. Okay. I'm still hiding.
Left of our movement. Current movement moving forward in our direction. Next movement moving backwards in our direction. Is there vibration to left of orientation? One click, right of orientation, two clicks. Fuck.
Yes, so both ways. Okay,
but hey, I made the supercomputer my bitch. That's a plus.
I'm still
and
hiding.
And I don't have to listen to her. Bonus.
I'm gonna peek. I'm just gonna peek around the corner, just tilt my head in, that's it. No.
Okay.
Nothing
so
else.
I love that though, dude. That you're just like the random binary over the radio.
Yep.
And it's just like seriously, I did that. I didn't think that through at all.
No.
Oh, that is awesome. Good on you, man. Good. That's quick.
That's not quick. I mean, like I was completely confused as to what you were doing, but the moment you started ringing up a radio connection, I was like, this thing can't speak. This thing barely gets, like, text communication, let alone fucking verbal.
What would have you done if I hooked it up to the robot? Would it just, like, flailed in the corner? Because that's why I was asking about locomotion.
It would have probably killed us both.
Or made us its bitch. It was just, like, start humping us like a dog.
Yeah, so, it's like,
it's like you're my drone now.
Machine.
So Savrik goes forward. He peeks into the room on the left of where he is. He peeks into the room on the left, and he sees it could roughly be described as a like orangutan, maybe, or at least it was originally. It appears to have a crystal embedded in its chest, and it has been covered in mutinous growths.
That's what we would have been looking for. Okay.
All right. And
I still love how that chick just like opened up her shirt and then realized like, oh, this guy's a complete boob.
And in this room to my right.
There is a creature that appears to be some kind of possibly it's mammalian, but maybe like it's a quadrupedal mammalian, maybe a horse or something like that. And it again is covered in growths, quite distinctly covered in growths.
Okay.
And it looks at you, by the way, as you look in through the window.
Wait.
This whole area is without oxygen. That's...
Yes.
Yeah. So,
Are you sharing this information?
I'm open.
How did you share that information?
Stream of consciousness, open mic, just shit, no, back out. I'm not dealing with this.
Like, there's maybe a horse in here?
There's a something. There's a something. Let's go this way.
Okay, so I'm standing here without, okay. So, back communicating with, compu bitch.
Yep.
Okay, if immediate danger, or if convergence of alternate targets are detected in relation to flagged essential targets, beep 5 times, then 5 consecutive beeps. As a confirmation, yes, single beep, no double beep. Do other targets in area pose threat to flagged essential targets? Yes and no.
So certain are, certain aren't. Stick on the outside and follow my path. We're gonna get out of here.
Do targets not flagged essential possess greater locomotive speed or equal locomotive speed to targets flagged essential? 1 click yes, 2 click no. They can all run faster than us.
Yeah, why do you think I'm...
Do we bother with this shit? Or do we just run the hell out of here? Do we want to check it in?
We have...
Like, at this point, like, you tried to kill a dog man Pillsbury Doughboy. Do you want to see what the horse is about?
Nope.
But it could be, My Little Pony.
Either way,
okay, yeah, fuck that, I'm gone.
Okay. We're going this way. Okay. We're just gonna... These doors, this back entrance, exit, airlocks.
Okay.
Are they all closed or open?
They are unlocked.
Okay. Let's
Wait, there's let's a tri-door here? Holy crap, that's a thing. You went ham on this map, eh?
Wow.
Hey, Droid, you still with us?
Yep, I'm here. I was just dealing with Discord.
Yeah, you went crazy on this next map, eh? That's awesome.
Okay.
Radio back.
The whole
In moving in directional vector that essential targets are moving, is there still vibrational input? Can it still be tracked? 1 for yes, 2 for no. Okay, so we can still be tracked through here. So we can still query the computer.
Before we go any further, it is 12:40 in the morning. This has been a 5 hour plus recording, just about. Shall we call it?
Brand new map. We don't know what's happening yet. Caller here.
Yep, yes. Sounds fine, buddy.
Okay, do you want to do a wrap-up for us?
I will indeed do a wrap-up. First off, thanks, guys, for playing.
Oh, thank you so much, Droid. This has been ridiculous.
This is orgasmic.
So, just to wrap up for the guys who are watching and for you guys, so in this session, we started off in the armory where we left off before. We finished raiding the armory. We headed off to the command room, and you found a small amount of information, a couple of names. You then found a secret lab containing a couple of zombies, which you dealt with reasonably handily, and a creature that essentially begged you to kill it. Eventually, you did kill it, despite the fact some of you had minor mental breaks because of this, at which point it went insane and tried to kill you back, despite it had no head. You then went back to the med lab, tortured the poor fucking med woman, nearly turned her into a zombie. Samuel had a mental break. You nearly tortured Samuel as well.
How did we nearly torture Samuel?
You were going to take his game away from him.
Fair enough. Okay.
You then went to the airlock where there were 4 survivors held up together. one of them burst into tears the moment you mentioned that you killed the dogs, and you were chased out at gunpoint. You traveled across the surface of the moon to a secret base and found four giant computers that were powered by a organic network wrapped around a crystal. You connected one of them to the station, which seems to have pleased it greatly. And then you seem to be sort of gathering information from it as you go around. So far as you know, it seems to think that human beings are useful targets for drone work, but don't have the required development to be anything more. And you have moved through the station and met some rather creepy creatures and into the start of what appears to be a giant cave system.
I kind of want to go back to the computer and have it display information on those critters. But I guess I'll
have
to leave that till next time.
Just, wow. Just, my brain is just gone.
I love how, like, you thought this was going to be a one-day session, too. And it's turned into, like, multiple, like, it's more than 8 hours now of this thing that you created.
Thank you for playing.
Yeah.
Thank you for watching. I will see you at the next session.
See you later, Droid.
Thank you for hosting.